Percubaan 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, hello guys. Welcome back to our topic, which is the permanent magnet DC motor. So, as you can now, you can see at this figure here. Okay, this is the schematic circuit or the schematic diagram for the permanent DC motor. Okay, actually the permanent DC magnet is quite different compared to the shunt DC motor because the special part the DC motor was pulled are made of the permanent magnet. Okay, so there are no external field circuit here. They just install the fixed field magnet. So that one the amateur part. Okay, so this one the load side and one is the rotor. Okay, so the permanent magnet DC motor offer a number of benefit compared with DC shunt motor in some applications since this motor do not require an external field circuit. Okay, they have no field circuit. Just remember the permanent magnet, there no field circuit. They install with the fixed field, which is the permanent magnet. Okay, because no field winding are required, they can be a smaller than corresponding shunt DC motor. So in term of size, okay, in term of size, the permanent magnet is a smaller in size. So in when the size is quite small, so this is a less expensive, simpler and higher efficiency than corresponding DC motor with a separate electromagnetic field. Okay, commonly the size is up to about 10 horsepower. Okay, but in a recent some of motor has been built in up to 100 horsepower. Okay, so however this permanent magnet also they have some advantages because the permanent magnet cannot produce as a high flux density as external supply field circuit. So the permanent magnet will have the lower induced torque. Okay, so you can remember what is the advantage. They have a lower induced torque per ampere of armature current than a shunt motor of same size and construction, even the same size, but it cannot produce a high induced torque. So it is quite low induced torque. So this is the some disadvantage of the permanent magnet DC motor. So you just remember here the permanent magnet. If you want to remember the permanent magnet, is they don't have the field external field circuit. So they install the fixed field here. We can call as the permanent magnet. Okay. Okay. So this is the series DC motor. So you just imagine the part of the different type of DC motor, they have a different of equivalent circuit. So according to this one, you have been justified, you just study about this one in the lab one, okay, about the series DC motor and the shunt DC motor. So according to the series connection of DC motor, okay, a series DC motor is a DC motor whose field winding consists of the relatively few turns connected in series with the armature circuit. Okay, so this is the series DC motor. So according to this one, you can use the KVL, okay, KVL to get the value of VT here, the voltage terminal. So this one the output here. Okay, this one the IL, so the IA, the armature current is equal to the IS and equal to the ILoad. So this is the normal equation for the induced torque. So you can play around. So if you know this is the series DC motor, so you can apply the KVL. Okay, this is a tips for you. Okay, if the question show the DC series, okay, or the shunt, okay, so for the first step, you need state the first equation. What is the equation? So, for example, for the series, the value of IA equal to IS and equal to IN. So you can do the VT. So this is the parameter, important parameter before you start another calculation to get the speed, okay, and get to the internal generated voltage to get the value of IF, for example. Okay, so you must remember the equivalent circuit. Okay, in the textbook, you can refer the page number 495. So they have explained in terms of the terminal characteristic of the DC motor. So the DC motor is quite different compared to the other type DC motor because this is the non-linear analysis. Okay. So according to this one, the torque speed characteristic for the series DC motor, this is the exponential curve. Okay, because this is non-linear here, so this one the exponential curve. So based on the speed and torque induced. Okay, so you can refer to the page 496. So based on this one, one of disadvantage of the serial motor can be seen immediately from this equation. When the torque of this motor, okay, when the torque on this motor goes to zero, its speed goes to infinity. Okay, this is one the advantage. Okay, in practice, the torque can never go entirely to zero because of the mechanical core and stray losses that must be overcome. However, if no other load is connected to the motor, it can turn fast enough seriously damage itself. Okay, you remember, if no load is connected to the motor, it can turn fast. Okay, it can turn fast enough to seriously damage itself. So, must connected to the load. Okay, however, if no other load is connected to the motor, okay, I just repeat back. If no other load is connected to the motor, it can turn fast enough to seriously damage it. Never completely unload a serial motor and never connect one to a load by a belt other mechanism to code break. Okay, if that were to happen and the motor were to become unloaded while running, the result could be serious. Okay, so you must remember the curve here. So when the torque induced is zero, so the speed will be infinity. So if no load here, so it will become the speed is fast enough and can damage itself. So this is the characteristic of the series DC motor. Okay, for the speed control of a DC series motor, unlike with a shunt DC motor, there are only one efficient way to change the speed of series DC motor. That method is to change the terminal voltage of the motor. So we need to change the terminal voltage of motor. If the terminal voltage is increased, the first term in the equation torque speed relationship is increased, resulting a higher speed for any given torque. So this is the equation, the speed motor. So equal to Vt over K, see, 1 over square root of torque induced minus with the Ra plus Rs over KC. So this is the torque speed relationship for the torque speed characteristic for the series DC motor. Okay, this one, this is the compounded DC motor. So normally we can call as the compounded DC motor as a motor with both shunt and series field. Okay, they have a series and they have a shunt series field. Okay, so the dot that appear one to field coil have the same meaning as the dot on the transformer. Okay, so the dot is a transformer here. So the current flow into the dot produce a positive magnetomotive force. So if the current flows into the dot on both field coil, the resulting magnetic force combine to produce a larger total magnetomotive force. So in situation is also known as a cumulative compounding. Okay. So this one, the dot, so when the flow in to the dot here, so we can call as a cumulative compounding. If the current flow into the dot on the field, okay, so the dot to the field, so if the current flow on the dot on one field coil and one out of the dot one, then other field coil, the resulting magnetic force is supplied. So this one the schematic circuit here, okay. They have a square, okay. They have a square and they have a the circle here. So if they enter the square here, we can call as the differentially compounded. Okay, alright. So this is the equation. So based on the KVL, so IA is equal to the IA here equal to IL minus with the IF. So IF equal to VT over RF. So this one is some equation the same with the shunt Hishimoto. Okay, this one the top speed characteristic of the cumulative compounded DC motor. This one the cumulative compounded DC motor. Okay, in the cumulative compounded DC motor, there are a component of flux which is constant, and another component will be proportional to the armature current. Okay, so therefore the cumulative compounded has a higher starting torque. Okay, they have a higher starting torque. Then the shunt motor, okay, so the flux is constant but the lower starting torque than a series motor, so the whole entire flux is proportional to the armature current. Okay, in a sense, a cumulative compounded DC motor combine the best features of both of shunt and series motor. Like a series motor, it has extra torque of starting, like the shunt, it does not over speed at no load. At the light load, the series feel very small, so the motor behave as approximately as a shunt DC motor. As the load get very large, the series flux become quite important, and the torque speed curve begin to look like of the series motor characteristic. Okay, so to determine the characteristic curve, okay, to determine the characteristic curve for the cumulatively compounded DC motor by non-linear analysis. So the approach is similar to the for the shunt and series motor see before. Okay, so this is if you remember, the shunt is a linear and the series is the non-linear, which is like exponentially curve here. So this is the cumulative compounded because there's a combination between the shunt and series. Okay, so I think we can do for the example for this analysis for the cumulative compounded DC motor. So this one the torque speed, no load rating. So this one the shunt, okay, the more speed and torque here. So this one the cumulatively compounded. Okay, this one the torque speed characteristic of differentially compounded DC motor. Okay, so the shunt magnetic force and the series magnetic force subtract for each other, so that's why the curve like this one. So this means that as the load on the motor is increased, the means the IA increase and the flux motor will be decreased, but the flux decrease, the speed motor will be increased. This speed increase cause and other increase the load, which further increase of IA. Okay, therefore decreasing the flux and increasing the speed again. Okay, the result is a differentially compounded motor is unstable and tend to run away. This is instability at a much worse than that of shunt motor with a armature reaction. So it is so bad than the differentially compounded motor, which is the unsuitable for any application. To make matter worse, it is impossible to start such a motor, a starting condition of armature current and the series field current very high. Since the series flux of strength from the shunt flux, the series field can actually reverse the magnetic polarity of the machine pole. Okay, the motor will typically remain still or turn slowly in the wrong direction while burning up because the excessive armature current. When this type of the motor is to be started, its series field must be short circuit. So that is behave as an ordinary shunt motor during the starting period because of the stability problem of the differentially compounded DC motor. It is all small. It is almost never intentionally used. However, the differentially compounded motor can result if the direction of power flow reverse in cumulative compounded generator. So that reason, if the cumulative compounded DC generator are used to supply power to the system, okay, they will have a reverse power trip circuit to disconnect them from the line if the power flow reverse. There's no motor generator, no generator set in which power is expected to flow in both direction can use differentially compounded DC motor, and therefore it cannot use as a cumulative compounded generator. Typically, characteristic compounded can we see at the at this figure. Okay. So when we can call as the subtract of the magnetic force from each other.